This past weekend, we had two beautiful days, and it allowed Kevin and I a chance to work in the greenhouse a little bit. We moved everything around, and we put down the ground cover that we've been using in the garden in the floor of the greenhouse to make it easier this spring and summer. So I want to show you the work we did, but also the lettuce in the raised bed looks fantastic, so we're going to cut some for lunch. Let's go inside. It's not all set up for seed starting yet because it's a little bit early, but it was really nice to get a jump start in here. We think the ground cover looks fabulous. It will stay a lot cleaner in here, and just not having to deal with the weeds in here over the summer and the spring will be really awesome. But come down here and take a look at this beautiful lettuce. Last spring, we planted lettuce in this bed, and over the summer it went to seed and reseeded itself. So all of this lettuce that's in here actually just grew from the seeds that dropped down. So for it being a volunteer garden for our winter, it's been pretty awesome. There are other things growing in the raised bed as well, especially chickweed, which Kevin planted last year. It's kind of gone crazy and is growing like all over the place, and that's actually okay, it's edible. There are some other weeds and stuff, big deal, we'll take care of those another time, we'll just cut around them. But we're really excited to be able to provide fresh greens for the family during the middle of winter. This patch of chickweed right here is so succulent. I'm going to cut some of this for our salad as well. This mix of lettuce is called Rocky Top mix from Baker Creek. It has been our most favorite mix of lettuce so far. Well, I think that's a good amount for our lunch today. I'm gonna go inside and get this cleaned up. And in the meantime, Kevin is gonna pan fry a couple of the quail that he just recently harvested from our quail.
So for our lunch today, we're going to be having a couple quail that I processed a few days ago. We have a video of that on our Patreon page if you want to see how we process them. But we're going to make just a real simple pan-fried quail today. I've just taken some flour, some organic flour, added some salt and pepper, and we're just going to put the quail in and flour them on both sides. And then we're going to pan fry them in some lard that we rendered from our pigs that we raised this last summer. Now, if you guys don't know the health differences between homemade lard, home rendered lard, and store-bought lard, I suggest that you do some research into that. There's some pretty major differences in the way that you make it at home and what that does to the types of fat to your body. So it's definitely worth looking into. We're just going to let these fry on about 3 to 4 minutes on each side. Quail is, it's kind of like rabbit. It's a really lean meat, so you don't want to overdo it. You want to cook it till it's done, but you don't want to go any longer than you have to or the meat will dry out. So we're just going to let these go about 3 or 4 minutes and then flip them over. Now these are Coturnix quails, but you could do the same thing with you know, quail that you would hunt as well. We just don't really have many wild quail here in this part of southern Missouri. This is just two quail. We've got the back legs here that I'm just flipping now. And then this is the breast and wing. It may not look like a lot of meat, but quail is such a dense meat. It really fills you up, especially for a lunch. No need to go overboard. You don't want to eat so much that you're tired and don't want to do anything the rest of the day. So this with the salad that we just picked, and we have some chicken and rice soup on the wood stove, is going to be a perfect lunch. So the quail is done. Look how gorgeous that looks. Nice and crispy on the outside from that flour. Those are going to be great.
Well, let's go take this to the table. It needs to rest and cool down a little bit. We'll check on the soup, and there are some things we want to talk about. I think it needs a little bit more time.
Well, you guys, before we have our lunch, we wanted to take a few minutes to sit down and talk to you and thank you because this past weekend we hit 100,000 subscribers here on YouTube. It's just been mind-blowing to us.
It's just so amazing. We can't even believe it, and you guys just don't understand how absolutely grateful we are to you. We get such amazing comments and compliments, suggestions, ideas from you guys. And we are just forever, forever grateful.
Yeah, please know that even though we can't always respond to every comment that you guys leave, we do read almost all of them that we get. So when you leave us a tip or a comment, even some criticism, we read all of it. And we sure do appreciate that you guys are following us along. So we wanted to do something to say thank you to all of you. So we're going to be doing another giveaway, some things that we find very helpful and useful here on the homestead. So we wanted to tell you guys about those today.
We talk about each one of them a lot. I'm sure that you've seen them in our videos.
So now you'll have these things on your homestead that you can use as well. So the first prize that we're going to be giving away is a 6-quart enameled Dutch oven. If you saw the recipe that I did recently about baking bread in a Dutch oven, a lot of you guys loved that video, but we heard from a lot of you that you don't own a Dutch oven. So we thought this would be a great way to be able to provide one to one of you who watches our videos. Now we are doing the enameled Dutch oven because it's a little bit easier to use. You don't have to worry about seasoning and everything like that, but they cook great because they're still cast iron.
We don't even have an enameled Dutch oven yet, but I have some Christmas gift card money left over, and so I'm gonna be getting one too. So in the future, you'll be able to see me cooking in the kitchen with our own enameled Dutch oven.
I still prefer my antique Dutch oven.
Hey, I like it too, but then this one will be mine, and that one can be yours.
True.
We're also going to be giving away a Presto pressure canner, the double stack. I started out with the Presto canners for the pressure canner, and I learned very easily. They're super easy to use, super easy to learn. I felt really confident learning on that. Now, it's not the All-American pressure canners, which I also have one of those, but the Presto canners, I think, are easier to learn on and are a lot less intimidating. So we'll be giving one of those away too, and I'm super excited for one of you.
The third thing that we're going to be giving away is something that you guys know I love to use because it means tomato season is here, and that is the Cocina tomato processor. This little gadget is awesome. When I first saw it, it's made out of plastic. When I first saw it, I thought, this thing is going to be a hunk of junk. We're never going to use it. I picked it up at a garage sale for like $2, and I thought, you know what, we'll shove it in the barn and we'll never use it. We use this thing every year to process so many tomatoes. I mean, hundreds of pounds of tomatoes go through our processor every year, and this thing works no fail. So we'll be giving away one of those to you so that you can have it before tomato season gets here this year. So you can process all those tomatoes, you can boil them down in your new Dutch oven, and you can process them in your new canner.
Hey, that's true.
Except not one person's gonna win everything.
That's true. To enter our giveaway, you just need to comment below. We will be randomly choosing winners, and we will be announcing it 1 week from today. This giveaway is open to our US viewers. Because of shipping, we just can't ship internationally.
So our hope is that these prizes will go to people who will use them on a regular basis and can really have a need for them. So make sure you leave in your comments if you don't want one of these prizes. We'll make sure that your name is still in for the other prizes when we draw for those.
Well, it sounds like the soup is bubbly, so it's time to eat. I made a quick homemade vinaigrette for the salad. It has olive oil, white wine vinegar, salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and some oregano. And honey. This is gonna taste amazing.
Well, lunch smells delicious, but unfortunately, we didn't make enough for everybody, so this is going to end our video for today. You guys, thank you so much. You really are the reason that our channel is successful, and we want you to know just how thankful we are. Don't forget to leave your comments below, and we'll be drawing those prizes in a week.
Don't forget, if you enjoy our channel, please subscribe. We would really appreciate it. Don't forget to follow us on all of our social media, including Instagram. And until next time, thanks so much for stopping by the homestead. Take care and God bless.
God bless.